What is up, folks? This is Aragast, and welcome back to Dark Souls 2, Scholar of the First Sin. Alright, so here we are.
I ought to fetch a new
Ember. Our dear Ember flame person. But yeah, we're gonna do a couple things. First, we're going to reinforce our sword. Because we have plenty of Twinkling Titanite to go ahead and upgrade it from 4 to 5, which is going to top it off. Awesome. Alright, so the other thing that we're going to do is to go ahead and infuse it. Now, what are we going to infuse it with? I'm hoping we're going to infuse it with fire. Alright, so the reason that we're doing this is because it's going to take it down not a whole lot, but it's going to add a decent amount of fire damage to it. So, yeah, I think it's going to be worth it. Especially if we had a bunch of faith, which we don't at the moment, but we're going to get some more faith in the future, so that's not too bad. This isn't the weapon that I plan on using for the longest time either, so I think we'll be just fine. The reason a lot of people would tell you not to do something like that is because you're splitting your damage in a way that could be very, very harmful. And what I mean by that is if something is resistant to fire as well as their normal physical armor, you're getting reduced twice. So your damage is getting reduced by your physical and by your fire, as opposed to being just a reduction to your physical. But we already had a decent amount of fire damage, so, you know, kind of balancing them out isn't, I don't think, that big of a deal. Alright, so let's go ahead and head back to Shulva, because there's one area that I at least want to show you guys. I'm not sure how much time I'm going to spend on it, because it's really a multiplayer area. It's not meant especially for single player, and it's not that way either. But I have beaten them before, but it was a long slog to get through them. And you'll see what I mean when we get there. But it'll take a little bit to get there. And in the meantime, there's actually some more loot to pick up and stuff like that, and areas to show you and whatnot. Let's go ahead and send this back up. Okay. And run across the bridge. So there's the way that we went, which was down. There is also another way, but I have to remember where it is. I don't think actually this is the way. I remember we get to the top of the pyramid, but honestly, I can't really remember how to get there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to find the way real quick, and then I'm going to be right back with you guys. Okay, folks, so after I realized where I needed to go, I felt a little silly because earlier I told you, hey guys, this key is really important. Well, Eternal Sanctum key used. It is really important. Fortunately, you have these guys to deal with. Oh, hey. The second hit should have killed him. I was sure there were three of them in here. I guess not. There's a lot of blitzing around here. Oh, hey. That wasn't cool. Three hits, huh? Why are there so many... Oh, whoopsie-daisy. Alright, so let's do that. And then use that. Okay. We're fine. We're fine. There's a lot of blood stains around here, though. Something attacked them on the way up. I'm just making sure these things... Okay. I feel pretty comfortable opening them now. There's no blood stains on that side of the room, so I feel okay. Dried root. Whoa. Dried root. Hold on just a second. What's in this one? Dried root. So one, two, three. Is there four on this one? If I remember right, all of these are kind of crappy anyway. Lightning clutch ring. Okay. Increases lightning damage, by the way. And bonfire aesthetic. Okay, so that one wasn't too bad. And neither really was the other one, but the dried root, eh. If I remember right, there's something like right at the top up here that you have to worry about. I think they're bugs. So let's head up here and be on our guard and not deplete our stamina completely. Yeah, I can hear them. Yeah, I thought so. Roll, please. We don't want to go too far the other way, though. Just yet. We'll go out there in a minute. Yes, there's a bonfire. Yes, it's very enticing. But let's head up here first. Unless they've changed what's up here, it's usually pretty safe. Or it should be pretty safe, unless you're invaded. And if you're invaded, then... If they come up here, then, I mean, they're pretty good. Okay, there's nothing. You can light these, but they don't do anything. Okay. You know what? Let's light them anyway. Just because. We usually light everything, so why not? Set light. Set light. Cool. And you can see them from over there, which is kind of neat. Just adds a bit of atmosphere. I'm not sure if there's any other reason you would ever do it, but why not? Okay, so let's head over here. This guy usually isn't that hard. But he can be a bit of a pain. He is a shield, or a spear user, by the way. Or I'll take a little bit of damage, but at least the bonfire's lit. Oh. I was already behind him. Darn it! It's getting in the way. I can't see for the pillars. Oh. We can't heal. Interesting. Some of these, I've noticed, you can't heal. I think it's mainly just the DLC guys that you can't heal from. Oh, darn it. And a stamina. One more hit for him, I'm dead. One more hit for me, he's dead. Oh. Well, you're gonna do that. But why he can heal and I can't, that's cheap. But he's dead. Human effigy. That is an NPC, by the way. So, just in case you're curious. You can hit this to do the elevator. Which, basically, it's just the one that's at the bottom of this tower. If you remember the bridge with the dragon, it's right there. Alright, we're right above my head. So, it's just the building before that. There's nothing down there that you really need to go and get. This place. Yeah. It's not the nicest of places. I like it not. Yeah. You can go ahead and come along with me. That's fine. Come on, folks. Alright, so I would recommend doing this, just so you can see a bit better. He does have cast light, which is nice. Don't get me wrong. And really, these guys are very helpful just because this area has a lot of mobs. Nice. So I'm just going to go ahead and light these up the first time through, just so we can see for the future times. And he enchants his sword with lightning, which is nice. All these things are really annoying. Nice. Let's go over here and get this item. Bonfire setting. Nice. Oh, it looks like they're ganging up on him. Ow. That's petrify, by the way. Which is not a nice thing to be hit with. I would not recommend coming down here by yourself. If you really want, you can dismiss them later. And these things actually walk around, so they're not very kind either. I think there's something... Yeah, there's definitely something over there. These are NPCs, by the way, so you can just wander around to your heart's content. Bright Bug, okay. Which is a nice enchant. This way is a chest, so let's grab this. Petrified something times three, which is really nice, excuse me. There are lights down here that you can light up. And you can, as always, kill these that are just standing at their own. But like I said before, I don't know how much time we're going to be spending in this area, just because the boss for it is just so difficult that, and the reward is not that great, that it's not really all that worth it, I don't think. It's interesting, don't get me wrong, and it is nice, I just don't know that it's worth it. The best way to do this area, by the way, is to run through it by yourself. And then if there's somebody that wants to be summoned down here, summon them right before you go through the door. That way you don't actually have to fight anything. Because if you have to fight things constantly, this area is just not much worse. I don't think there's anything actually back here. But you can roll through these as always, so. And yes, you have worms to fight again, so. Enjoy that. Come on! Trying to backstab him constantly and it's just not working because my ally is standing between me and him. These guys do hurt if you stand in front of them when they charge, by the way, so I mean, I imagine you can imagine that, but you know, just be aware. They may look easy and they may be easy, but they can be worse. Alright, so in this one we have an archer, we have a tank, and we have that guy with the dual katanas. I'd recommend going after this guy first. Hopefully the other guy didn't follow me. Yeah, he uses a rapier, which is so fast. Honestly, both of these guys are. But they're holding up the tank, so... So there's at least that. These guys can be sort of staggered, though. This was actually not where I meant to fall off. Oh, come on. But yeah, there's those three guys. But I'm not going to deal with them, at least not right now. I might come back to them later when I've leveled up a bit more. But they're pretty rough. I would recommend actually taking them on either solo or with a human character. I would not recommend taking them on with those NPCs. That would not be my first choice. You know what? I think we're going to head to the King's Gate. Alright, so this isn't actually the way that you're really supposed to approach this. But it's the way that I'm going to approach it because I would really like to get the Watcher armor. I really like the Watcher set. I don't know. I imagine the Drake set is actually better though. I don't know. I'll have to actually take a look before I buy the Watcher set. But kind of figure at least one of you would come alive. But that was your mistake. Might not get the backstab, but three hits is all I need. You're okay. As long as those guys don't come alive. Alright, so all you have to do is wear the King's Ring. So just put it on. And that's all you need. Oh, Yorg's ring sometimes deflects spells. I don't like the ring just because really you should be trying to not be hit by spells to begin with. And there's lightning crutch pleasuring. Which does help out, but honestly, lightning's been nerfed so hard that it's still really not that great. I'm just using this one, right? Alright, so hopefully this area isn't too dark for you guys. Okay, so Shanalot's not here just yet. We'll talk to her later when she comes to this place. We're probably just going to be using the Drake Blood set, but I guess there's not really a reason not to come down here. And usually the boss that's after this is easier anyway. But I guess it gives me a little bit of a chance to talk about the queen that we face down there. So the theory is, or actually it's kind of fact, that she was born from a shard of Manus. And Manus is basically darkness incarnate. We fought him in the DLC of Dark Souls 1. Which honestly is an amazing DLC. It really is. It's pretty much my favorite DLC of any game, period. But yeah, so that tells you a little bit about who these queens are. Wasn't there somebody else we can summon here? Or two? Oh. Okay, so the second person you can summon is Vengarl. But we haven't fought his body yet. And I haven't seen his body yet, so I guess we can't summon him until we fight and kill him. We'll try this out without them. So this is one of the last bosses in the game, but it's not the last boss. This one, as you can imagine, is... Oh, wow. Did a lot of damage. This one is actually a lot easier if you're a spellcaster, but this guy's just kind of ignoring me. And the armor that I'm wanting is the one that I'm targeting. Now, you want to bring these guys down evenly, because if you don't and kill one of them, the other one will come over and revive you. So... or dodge one of his attacks. imagine the Watcher is going to come over and land me in a second. No, they're both just kind of focusing on Benhart, which is fine, I think. But they both gain, yeah. So they gain attacks, and it's kind of painful when they hit you, so just watch out. One method is to wait until the second one goes over and tries to resurrect and heal the other one, and then to lay into him. So we got the Throne Defender Soul and the Throne Watcher Soul from that. Nice. Well, there's bloodstains everywhere. But there's another boss that you'll fight in this room, but you won't fight that one until a little bit later. So let's go ahead and use a Homeward Bone. Use, yes. So I'm going to look at a few stats here for a couple minutes, and then I will be back with you guys, because I'd like to see what set is better, the Drake Blood set or the Throne Watcher set. Alright, so I'll see you in a minute. Okay folks, so the Drake Blood set is quite a bit better in pretty much every respect. It's like 3 pounds heavier, but it's, in my opinion, just flat out better. And pretty much empirically, it's just flat out better. Okay, so that takes 8,300 more souls than I've got. I'd like to... Let's see how much of the Drake Blood set I can actually wear. I haven't tried. I know it's heavy, but how much heavier is it? 4.7. Sanctum Dringlaek. Am I wearing the Drake Blood? Oh, I am wearing the Drake Blood gauntlets. Can I wear the Drake Blood pants? I think actually I tried this. Yeah, and I can't. I'd like to. Let's go ahead and do the vitality. Until hope. Level up. Oh, I should have... Silly me. Confirm, yes. Alright, so what I should have done was go ahead and see if I have enough of just like a random soul to be able to... Yeah, this one's 10,000. Okay, good. Oh, this is a great hero, so this is 20,000. What it can allow us to do is upgrade a piece of our armor a little bit, which...
Bearer of the curse, until...
Level up. Alright, so... Take us to 22. We might be able to wear it now and not get over 70%. That would be really nice. I'd definitely go for that. Alright, let's see... If I can... Yep, I can. Awesome. So dark protection goes down, but everything else, like, doubles. Pretty much. Like, everything, literally, yeah, a lot of this stuff actually doubles completely, or is a couple points away from doubling. Lightning protection, not so much. Fire protection, not so much, but a lot of the other things. Alright, so let's go ahead and wear that. We're pretty awesome looking. And we'll just stick with this helm. Why? Just, I like it better. Alright. And we can still roll.
Oh, I'd give you...
I'm not dead. Have more faith. Alright, so. Let's go ahead and go down here, and... That's the Hide Knight, right? Yeah, okay. Where is it? All the way at the bottom. Okay, so Drake Blood Armor. Let's go ahead and... Upgrade? Oh, and they just take Titanite Shards. Nice. That is actually really nice. I figured they would take something that was a little more expensive, like Twinkling Titanite. And actually, because it is just Titanite, I don't have enough souls.
I'll be around if you make...
Yeah. Alright, so our next boss kill, we'll go ahead and finish upgrading that stuff. Or upgrade it as far as we can, anyway. Or if we find ourselves with a lot of souls at some point. Alright, so we've taken out this area. So that DLC's done with. We have fought the... Am I remotely dead? No. Okay, darn. I'm not going to die just to go in there. We have fought the first end boss, quote-unquote. But after that, what we need to do is head back to the Shaded Woods and go into the Ruined Fork Road. Let's do this. I'm tempted to head to the second DLC and just go after the sword, but... I hate the Fume Knight. Oh my gosh, how I hate the Fume Knight. I love that sword, but oh my gosh. Darn. This sword is just so slow. Hello. So he's going to be a little bit harder now that we don't have spells. Oh my gosh. Talk about resistant to our weapon. I don't want to be hugged. But... Oh, please. Oh, come on. Hate trolls. Who doesn't hate trolls? Oh, ran into a wall. That was a little bit better. Oh, not good. Darn it. If only I had enchanted my sword. Darn it. We beat multiple bosses and die to a troll. Isn't that pretty much every internet experience? I mean, really? Isn't it? Oh, hey, we're partially dead. Well, I'm gonna kill this troll now. Do I want to show you guys what I wanted to show you? No. I want to kill the troll who just killed me. That's what I want to do. Hey! I rolled. Yeah, you're falling over on your back. You're cute. Not really. Hideous, but... Yeah, that without the ring that makes your spells last longer, the magic weapons don't last very long. The enchantments last longer. Actually, they work with the ring as well. So that's just something to keep in mind. All right, well you're dead. Good. I would say never come back, but you'll respawn, because that isn't the first time I've killed you. Alright. And I'll just leave those guys alone. Unless they come after me, which looks like they're going to do. Alright. These guys, don't let them fool you. They can do a lot of damage. Oh, come on. And they'll also petrify you. So when in large groups, worry. Affinity. Interesting. It's not actually a very good spell, but interesting. Alright, so we're running. Oh, hello. You're new. Greetings. I will do so. Give me a minute, I've got to kill the defender of the door. Alright, and we shall produce the symbol of the king, and not merely the symbol of a soldier. Okay, produced. Pardon me while I do this. And by the way, that soldier's ring. Obvious keep. So we've already killed him. In Brightstone Cove, Seldora, we killed him. And remember, I'm petrified dragon bone. Nice. What I said about large numbers, there's a lot of them here. One way to deal with them is to just do this, because they don't actually have a lot of health. But I warn you, as soon as you kill one of them, they really come after you. So. They're dead, but just be careful because you could be dead too. A learning skull. Alright, that we'll deal with in a minute. First, hello, old friend. Are you okay?
Who are you? Oh, no, forgive me. I know you. Yes, of course. How goes your journey? I know not what you seek in this faraway land, but I pray for your safety. Please take these. Consider this thanks for keeping me sane. My name is Lucatiel. I beg of you, remember my name, for I may not myself. My name is Lucatiel. I beg of you, for I may not myself.
Poor Lucatiel. But yeah. So, let's go ahead and head over here. And so, yeah, this. I hate mimics. There we go. He's dead. Dark Mask. A form skull. Alright, so basically the mask of the dark set that we were using earlier. Just basically a skull and bone set. It's heavy armor. And it's actually pretty good. But compared to a lot of the DLC armors, it's just not up to par. The Malformed Skull, again, it's a strength weapon that is not really all that special. Like, no, pretty much nobody uses it. There is an item around this left side, Twilight Herb. There is not around the other side. So, remember that the reason she's here is to find her brother. So, hello. Yeah, we wasted a lot of stamina trying to backstab him. Yeah, so this is her brother. And it's debatable as to whether... actually, that fight is much harder if you're not at the level that I'm at the moment. I mean, like, level of gear, level of, like, talented, you know, stuff. I mean, I'm not trying to say that it's... What the heck? What's going on? Okay. That's weird. If you've played before, you know what I'm talking about. Don't you dare light that. Okay, I'm undead. I do want to talk to him.
Well, you're nicely hollowed, aren't you? Are you tormented by memories? Burdened by guilt? Now the question, are you ready for more? If you are, then we ought to talk. This. This contains my power. Long ago, this naive vessel of mine set about devising new spells. The fool dreamt of bringing new forms of magic into the world. But instead, he created me. Mostly by chance, but he did a fine job, I must say. What he sought was strength, and so I decided to demonstrate. While my vessel slept, I'd find my mark and hunt him down. But my vessel did not approve. And so while I slept, he sealed the both of us away. No, I don't have anything against humans. But how is it that you go about defining good and evil? I'm only using what the gods gave me. How can that be so wrong? So what say you to a spot of murder on my behalf? If you don't, I'll leave this place and take more lives. Many more. I couldn't give a fig either way, so what's your choice? Yes, I see how very kind of you. I want you to kill a merchant named Gilligan. A greedy, foul man. He won't be missed, I assure you. Yes, bring me a ladder miniature as proof. Is the only person who'd have such an odd knick-knack. Fine work. This is my thanks. Take it. Now let's discuss our next mark. I want you to kill one more. Your target will be Kale, the man who's drafting that map. While I was trapped in here, he touched me, that maniac. Like I was some rare specimen. He wore a strange helm. Bring it back as proof. Yes, I knew I could count on you. Perhaps this will slake my thirst.
Okay, so we already had the ladder miniature from Gilligan, but we don't have the helm from Kale. The thing is, there are two ways you can go about getting each of the items. One is to kill the person, like you once, and the second is to, well, go about different ways to get it. I'm just confused about this thing. Really confused. But yeah, there's different ways for each of them. You can buy the one from Gilligan. For Kale, you can go ahead and light up all of the bonfires that are on the map. And then he'll give you the armor. These guys are really hard to backstab. But apparently he didn't want to do anything but stand there, so that's fine, whatever. Oh, he's stuck coming out of the mirror. That's new. He was just leaned up against a pillar, kind of like that guy over there, not hanging from inside it. Okay, there we go. And one more hit should do it. Maybe two. Well, yeah, probably was one. Okay, so that's what I was after. Northern Ritual Band plus two, and Petrified Dragon Bone. So not as quite as good as the loot from the DLCs. Actually, that's nowhere even close. But still you can see that it's, you know, decent. All right, so you can do this. You don't have to, though. And considering that I don't have any spells, it probably would have been better not to. I was afraid he was just going to sit on me. I'm not sure if you can backstab these guys or not. I don't think I've ever actually tried. Because they do just sit on you. And he likes standing up here, so... Ow. So, as usual, we'll probably have harder time with the trolls than with anything else. But... Oh, come on. That was totally within range. I just lure him into attacking, and then he can attack. That two-handed second attack is actually pretty good. Especially when you're on stairs. Because it slices upwards. So, Dragon Alkalite Mask. So, if you want that item, then kill him. If you don't, then whatever. Oh, I forgot about you. Usually I kill this guy with a bow, but since I'm recording, I guess I won't. Because it takes a long time to do it, but it's the safe way to do it. So, you know, it really depends on what you're after. All right, so bonfire aesthetic times two. That skeleton still just confusing the heck out of me. So as you can see, he can bust through his cage. But... I'll let you guys decide whether how dangerous he is. He's not that bad. I don't think, anyway. Alright, so Dragon Sage Hood. Interesting. There's some water. Really? I think these guys are just... Yeah, I don't really want to do that. But if you don't do the troll, then you come up a staircase that's over here. So... Just so you know. Just so's use knows. Go ahead and pull on this. Don't worry, it's not a trap. So much. Is it a trap? Sorta. But... Oh, that's new. Hello, Mimic. You didn't used to be there. Apparently he can't break out of his cage. Recommend hitting these paintings. You don't have to, but you're more likely to be ambushed if you're, you know, not hitting them. And these guys are more than anything. Alright. Alright, so... These trolls... I would recommend... That... You... Leave them alone. Unless you have a death wish. If you do have a death wish... Then go ahead and break them open. Alright, so there's an item over here. Ferrous Lockstone, awesome. Which you can use to light up the area if you want. And there's this. Which is a bonfire. And it's going to be the end of the episode as well. Alright, so next time we'll head up to an absolutely beautiful area. Probably one of the prettiest areas in the game. And there's some really nice ones. So, that's probably saying something. But, until then, I hope you guys did enjoy the episode, and I hope you have a wonderful day.